Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a new LEGO Pirates set. This is called the Brick Bounty. It comes with 7 minifigures and a total of 745 pieces. The ship is about 1.5 feet tall and a little bit longer than that. The hull is mostly constructed from 4 very large specialized boat pieces which have been around for quite a long time. They really speed up the building process and provide a lot of structural integrity to the base, but they take away a little bit from the building experience. The sails almost feel like a thick paper, but they're actually made of a synthetic cloth-like material that holds its shape pretty well. The sails won't tear very easily, and they're also water tolerant, but unfortunately the entire ship is not made to go in the water. It will not float. At the front of the ship, you've got a long angled bowsprit, and you've got a little captain skeleton there used for decoration. There's an anchor on a chain, and you can kind of raise and lower that there. You've got kind of a winch in the center that works in a very simple way just to let out some of that chain. The lower part of each mast is fairly securely attached, but the second part is a little bit on the loose side, so you don't want to mess with that too much. You've got very simple rigging here with the use of just Technic pieces, so you don't have to mess around with string and stuff to get these attached. It's very simple. All the way up at the top of the forward mast, you've got a crow's nest where you can put a minifigure there as an outlook. The second mast is set up in a very similar way, but it doesn't have a crow's nest, but it does have a little section where you can pose some figures up there. This thing in between is kind of made to look like a hoist or a crane of some sort, and it even has a hook on the end of it, but it's not able to get all the way down to the deck, so you can use it to hang some things up, but you can't really transport anything in and out with the help of this. So you can kind of rotate around and move to the side, but there's just not enough length there to be very useful. Down on the deck, you've got a lot of open space for posing and playing with the minifigures. You see a little rat back there. And then you have 2 of these spring-loaded cannons, plus a little tub of little cylinder pieces, black cylinder pieces that can be used as cannon balls, basically is what those are simulating. And you can put one of those in there. It's a little tough to get these out for my big fingers, but you can put one of these into each of the cannons, which can be hidden behind these flaps. You open them up to make it active. Just place that in there, and it's very simple to shoot that out. You just pull back from here and, oops, try that again. There we go. Wow, that just shot off my hand and bounced back. You can actually get quite a lot of distance out of these things. You can angle them up and down just a little bit. You can also remove the entire thing, so you can use this on land. You can also push these around different parts on the deck. You can attach them here, but they do have these 2 open spots, so you don't have all of them completely populated with cannons at all times. There is 1 other cannon back here on the upper deck, and this one can actually be rotated around. So that's actually a lot more useful for regular play. And there you've got your captain with his wheel. You've got a couple of nice little lamps along the sides, little banister section here, and this is kind of the major superstructure, which includes the interior section, which you can access from the front through the door there, or you can also go through a little archway that's kind of more for posing figures, or for you as a human to really access this. For the most part, you're going to want to take all this off, and it's super simple to just pull that off. It doesn't even have any studs to attach it. The interior space is pretty bare. There's not much furniture or anything. You've just got spots along the edges where you can place things. You can see a navigational tool there called a sextant. And this is just a treasure map. And you've got just a small little table right there with a glass or a bottle on top of it. That actually hides the hold where things are stored for cargo and such. And you just pull this up, that exposes that. That is actually a treasure chest down in there, so you have to kind of dig your fingers in even further. And there's the chest with kind of a handle on top to make it easier for you to pull it out. And when you open that up, you can see got a couple of bones in there and also a bunch of gems of various colors. With everything put back, you can see that this whole rear section of the ship actually looks really nice. This is the most finished looking part of the whole assembly, in my opinion. I think it just looks well finished. You've got your large flag back here, which is actually a printed piece, not a sticker. And down here, there's the little top of the rudder that would be sticking up above the water. And that's not attached to anything. It's not mechanized, but you can just turn it for posing. The blue coat soldiers in this set just get the smallest little rowboat. Notice that's molded in dark blue there. That's pretty nice. And for its major weapon, you get a stud shooter that's attached to the back. And they've got a little stack of these black stud pieces. You can turn that side to side. And you can use it to try to bombard the big pirate ship a little bit. Just push down from the top. It is fairly well attached, but I don't know. I don't think the balance of power is very much in the favor of these guys at all. Now let's take a closer look at all of the minifigures. On the pirate side, there you've got your captain, the first mate, the cook for the ship, and then a cabin boy. Then on the blue coat side, you've got an admiral, a sergeant, and a regular blue coat soldier. Here's a look at all of them from the back, and you'll notice that at first glance, it appears that none of these have alternate faces. However, one of them does. It's the Admiral here, who has a very scared alternate face. The set includes this new version of what they call a saw-nosed shark. New mold there. This is able to open its mouth up fairly far, and it's got some open space in there, so you can actually feed it stuff that can also come down. And lastly, they do also include just a few extra weapons as spares in the set that really aren't properly accounted for. With as many large pieces as this set has, you can't really look at the price per part as an indication of value. You have to kind of look at what all you get, you know, just get the feeling for the mass of stuff that's included once you assemble it all together. I feel like the value here, to me, is okay. It's definitely not great. I do wish there was more detail down on deck and or in the interior. They did put a fair number of small pieces into this set to give it, you know, ornamental little touches here and there. And certainly that rear section looks really good from the outside, but to me, this is just my personal opinion, I feel like there's a little bit of emptiness here. I feel like I wish there was a little bit more to this. And this is kind of a common problem with toy pirate ships. Let me know what you think about this set though, if you could take a moment to leave a comment with your thoughts. I would appreciate that very much. I appreciate your time in watching this video, and I hope that I've shown you everything that you wanted to see about this set. If you have any constructive criticism you'd like to leave, please feel free. Otherwise, stick around because more videos are on the way from me very soon. Catch you later.